yourselves asking, I signed up for a home show, well, now what do I do? That's what I'm here to help you with today. How to get the most out of your booth space. The most important thing you can do is plan in advance. Set specific goals for yourself. Establish a budget, and then decide on the contents of your exhibit. An example of a specific goal is something like, I want to set 15 appointments, or I want to generate 200 new leads. Whatever you decide on your company's goals should be, make sure you have a way of tracking them after the show. When you establish your budget, you're going to want to account for all components of the show, not just your booth space fee. This includes things like your exhibit expenses. What are you going to put in your exhibit space, and how much is that going to cost you? Shipping and storage. Your show services, things like internet and electric. Your staff costs, your salaries, hotel rooms, meals. All these things are going to contribute to your bottom line. When you decide on the content of your exhibit, there's something called the three-step, three-second rule. That means you have 3 steps, 1, 2, 3, or 3 seconds for every 10x10 to draw a consumer into your booth. The two most important things you want to convey are who and what. Who you are, your company name, and what you do, what products or services you offer. You're concerned that those 3 seconds aren't going to be enough time to grab somebody's attention? Consider upgrading your booth space. If you're struggling to come up with a plan for the design of your booth, our marketing solutions division can design and create custom space for you. Have a dress rehearsal of your booth. Tape out your space on your floor. Do your contents fit? Is there room for your staff to come in? Can visitors and potential customers come into your space? Then look at your booth and say, is this a neat, attractive, inviting display? You have a dress rehearsal, you can make these changes before the show starts. I like to use Keeper's Turf as an example of a great booth. I love their signage. It's clear if you can tell the company name, Keeper's Turf, what he does, and I love that he's utilized his flooring to showcase his products. Interesting backstory about them, we've actually become friends with Tom, the owner, over the last couple years. And he sent me this picture the other day, and it's Tremont Athletic Club in Tremont, Ohio, in Cleveland, which is a popular gym. And I'm like, how often are you in Cleveland? He says, well, 80% of my business is based in Cleveland, even though he's a Cincinnati company. And he told me that this year he's done over $150,000 in sales in the Cleveland market, which is why he keeps coming back to our show, because it's that successful for him. Something else you can do is let your booth speak for you. This gentleman from Lutz is a little bit on the quieter, shy side, so he builds his beautiful custom cabinetry in his space, and the cabinets truly do help sell themselves. Here's an example of a poorly constructed booth. Sloppy, wrinkled plastic tablecloths, and judging from that signage, as a consumer, I don't know their company name, and I certainly am not going to know what they do within 3 seconds of walking by their 10x10. Here's a flooring company that's just trying to do too much in their 10x10. They have too much product, it's cluttered, and it's not welcoming to their potential customers. This flooring company got it right. They have a multitude of products displayed, but they're organized and they're neat, and there's still space for people to come into their exhibit. Do's and don'ts of the show. Some do's. You want to be enthusiastic. SpongeBob. You want to be neat and well-dressed. You want to keep your booth space clean. Arrive early and make sure you're set up and good to go in your booth before your potential customers arrive at the show. And please stay until the show closes. Some don'ts. You don't want to be sitting or reading, chewing gum, eating, spittling on your phone. You want to be up and engaging with your potential customers. You don't want to ignore your prospects, but you don't want to go stalking them down the aisles either. Lastly, don't leave your booth unattended for extended periods of time. The longer you're away, the more customers you could be missing. If you still have questions about your booth